قال فإنا قد فتنا قومك من بعدك وأضلهم السامري فرجع موسى إلى قومه غضبان أسفا قال يا قوم ألم يعدكم ربكم وعدا حسنا أفطال عليكم العهد أم أردتم أن يحل عليكم غضب من ربكم فأخلفتم موعدي قالوا ما أخلفنا موعدك بملكنا ولكننا حملنا أوزارا من زينة القوم فقذفناها فكذلك ألقى السامري فأخرج لهم عجلا جسدا له خوار فقالوا هذا إلهكم وإله موسى فنسي.
But those he supposed to be following him had remained behind, for he, exalted be he, said, Indeed we tried your people after you, that is, after your departure from them, and the Samaritan led them astray, so they took to worshipping the golden calf. Thereupon Moses returned to his people, angry with them, and sad, extremely grieved. He said, O my people, did not your Lord promise you a fair promise, that is, a true promise, that he will give you the Torah? Did the period, the length of my absence from you, seem too long for you, or did you desire that wrath should become incumbent against you from your Lord, by your worship of the golden calf, and so you broke your tryst with me, and failed to follow after me?
أفلا يرون ألا يرجع إليهم قولا ولا يملك لهم ضرا ولا نفعا ولقد قال لهم هارون من قبل يا قوم إنما فتنتم به وإن ربكم الرحمن فاتبعوني وأطيعوا أمري قالوا لن نبرح عليه عاكفين حتى يرجع إلينا موسى قال يا هارون ما منعك إذ رأيتهم ضلوا ألا تتبعن أفعصيت أمري قال يا ابن أم لا تأخذ بلحيتي ولا برأسي إني خشيت أن تقول فرقت بين بني إسرائيل ولم ترقب قولي.
They said, We did not break our tryst with you of our own accord, read the mim with any of the three vowelings, meaning, by our own power or of our own will, but we were laden with, read Hamalna, we carried, or Hamilna, we were made to carry, the burdens, the weight, of the people's ornaments, of the trinkets of Pharaoh's folk, which the children of Israel had borrowed from them on the pretext of, using them for, a wedding, but which had remained with them, and we cast them, we threw them into the fire 348 at the command of the Samaritan, and so, just as we cast, did the Samaritan cast, what he had on him of their trinkets together with the dust that he took from the track left by the hoof of Gabriel's steed, as follows.
قال فما خطبك يا سامري قال بصرت بما لم يبصروا به فقبضت قبضة من أثر الرسول فنبذتها وكذلك سولت لي نفسي قال فاذهب فإن إن لك في الحياة أن تقول لا مساس، وإن لك موعدا لن تخلفه، وانظر إلى إلهك الذي ظلت عليه عاكفا، لنحرقنه ثم لننسفنه في اليم نسفا.
Then he produced for them a calf, which he fashioned from the melted trinkets, a mere body of flesh and blood, with a low, in other words, it made a sound that was audible. It was transformed into such a state because of the dust from Gabriel's steed, the effect of which is to create life in whatever thing it is placed. After he had fashioned it, he placed it, the dust, in its mouth. And they, namely, the Samaritan and his followers, said, "This is your God and the God of Moses." So he, Moses, forgot his Lord here and set off in search of him. God, exalted be He, says,
إنما إلهكم الله الذي لا إله إلا هو وسع كل شيء علما. كذلك نقص عليك من أنباء ما قد سبق، وقد آتيناك من لدنا ذكرا. من أعرض عنه فإنه يحمل يوم القيامة وزرا، خالدين فيه وساء لهم يوم القيامة حملا. يوم ينفخ في الصور ونحشر المجرمين يومئذ زرقا، يتخافتون بينهم إن لبثتم إلا عشرا. نحن أعلم بما يقولون إذ يقول أمثلهم طريقة إن لبثتم إلا يوما.
Did they not see that, in Allah, and has been softened in place of the hardened form, with its subject omitted, in other words, it should be, Anahu, it, the calf, did not reciprocate their words, that is, that it did not give them any response in return, nor did it have any power over hurt for them, that is, any power, to prevent it, or any benefit, that is, any power, to procure it, for them, in other words, how can such a thing be taken as a god? And Aaron had certainly said to them beforehand, that is, before the return of Moses, O my people, you are only being tested thereby. But truly your Lord is the compassionate one, so follow me, in worship of him, and obey my command, therein.
وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْجِبَالِ فَقُلْ يَنْسِفُهَا رَبِّي نَسْفًا. فَيَذَرُهَا قَاعًا صَفْصَفًا لَا تَرَى فِيهَا عِوَجًا وَلَا أَمْتًا. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَّبِعُونَ الدَّاعِيَ لَا عِوَجَ لَهُ، وخشعت الأصوات للرحمن فلا تسمع إلا همسا. يومئذ لا تنفع الشفاعة إلا من أذن له الرحمن ورضي له قولا. يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون به علما.
They said, "We will not cease to cling to it, persisting in worship of it, until Moses returns to us." He, Moses, said, upon his return, O Aaron, what held you back when you saw them going astray, by worshipping it? That, Allah, Reden, instead, the law being extra, you did not follow me? Did you then disobey my command, by remaining among those who worship, something, other than God, exalted be He? He, Aaron, said, O son of my mother, read Yabianayami or Yabianayama, meaning Ami, my mother, the mention of her is more effective in provoking the affection of his heart, do not clutch my beard, which he had seized with his left hand, or my head, for he had seized his hair with his right hand in anger. Indeed I feared that, if I followed you, for inevitably a group of those who did not worship the calf would have followed me, you would have said, you have caused division among the children of Israel, and have been furious with me, and you did not wait for my word, concerning what my opinion would have been in this matter. He said, and what have you to say, what was the motive for, doing, what you did, O Samaritan?